Alright guys, so welcome back to the channel. It's been a minute, and I obviously look a little bit different, shave my face and stuff like that, but we got something to show you guys today. So, Mason decided he was going to join the SS gang, and this thing's actually pretty dope, so.
What'd you buy?
This here is a 2003 Chevy Silverado SS. It has a pretty well built 6.0 all-wheel drive still, 4L65E that's built. It's got 140,000 on it. Plans are probably to go turbo with it. And, yeah, I mean, it's got some cosmetic issues, but...
Pop the hood. Let's see what it looks like underneath there.
It's got a stage 4 VTR cam. Ported, polished 317.
Got headers on it.
Speed Engineering, full exhaust, yep. High pressure oil pump, you know, just the basic full bolt on tune.
E fans for the 03.
Yep, yep. So,
and that actually, plug wires.
Yeah.
And still all wheel drive?
Yep, still all wheel drive. It's got a, like I said, a built trans that we're having a couple slight problems with.
Let's look at the inside.
That's the main reason, you know, kind of why I got it, because I want to build it and.
Oh yeah, normal.
Yeah, normal seat wear. Chevy seat wear.
How many miles are on it? 140,000. Not too bad.
Yeah, I think.
You got the yellow lettering on the wheels.
Yeah, yeah, I didn't do that.
SS wing.
The plan is probably just go a big single turbo, and then. You know, as you guys know, we got the Trailblazer SS that's blue, the Scat Pack that's blue, and now we have a SS Silverado that's blue.
Yeah, look at that. They match. That's crazy.
And
blue
really,
Silverado.
The plan with it is to be able to tow the Trailblazer to the Ice Cream Cruise or wherever we go with it. You know, a blue SS towing a blue SS would be pretty cool.
And I wonder what the tow rating is on this thing.
I don't know. I haven't figured that one out.
All-wheel drive does have a hitch. We can pull the blue Trailblazer SS.
This is a heavy girl here though, so no matter what, we are gonna have to take it a bit easy towing this thing with that.
It weighs about 4,600 pounds.
Yeah.
Not terrible.
Not terrible.
You know, the all-wheel drive SS, that thing actually has a tow rating of like 6,000 pounds. So technically, the all-wheel drive one could pull the rear-wheel drive one.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not bad.
But I wanted to show you guys that. I thought it was pretty cool. So here in a second, we're going to go out and I've actually got a draggy that's set up inside. So we're going to pull that out and get a time on it.
Yeah, I want to
see what that thing does.
We kind of want to get a baseline run.
Just to see what it does, you know?
It runs a little goofy. It needs a finalized tune. The tune's decent. It needs a finalized tune and it needs some trans work. But that's in the works already. We're going to get the trans fully rebuilt and built up for as much of a 4L65E can be, so yeah, I mean, I'll start it up for you guys. So
yeah, you guys can hear it. All right, so here's a start. A little bit of lope.
A little bit. I think it's just got a little bit of a misfire.
Yeah, it might just be a miss. Eh. Overall, it does look pretty good, though.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's on the stock SS wheels, which I find to be the best. I love these stock SS wheels.
Yeah.
It's got like 2.5-inch wheel spacers on it, and I don't know if we're going to take those off or not. These things sit pretty far out there.
All four.
As you can tell, it throws stuff all over the dang thing.
All right, got the draggy. You ready?
Yeah, let's go do it.
All right, we're gonna go try it out and see what this thing runs. Hopefully, what do you think it's gonna do?
Well, with these trucks being as heavy as they are, and it's not a race truck by any means, it's got a basic build. I am going to hope that it goes.
I'll say like a 14.5,
14.8, somewhere
around
there. Yeah,
hopefully. So, yeah. We're going to go get it figured out.
Oh, yeah.
Let's do it.
you guys a little green light action.
Pretty quick.
Not bad.
Nice. Well, let's see.
Yeah. Quarter mile.
So it just went a 14.3. What do you think about that?
I can't believe that. I'm amazed by what that just did.
It was a little quicker than I thought it was going to be. I was just giving it the benefit of the doubt whenever I said 14.5, thinking it was going to go maybe a 15.
Yeah, because stock, these trucks run a very high 15. Very high, like a 15.9, maybe 15.8 completely stock. And for it to run a 14.3 with just basic bolt-ons and a cam.
It's literally just a cam with head work.
Yeah, a cam with head work, and that's it. I mean, it's as basic as it
sounds pretty good.
Yeah, it's decent. I mean, the drivability is kind of, I mean, it's...
it's iffy.
Chain shifts nice and firm when it does shift. We're kind of having a little bit of a problem with the 2.3. Kind of slips sometimes, and sometimes you got to manually shift it, as you guys saw in the draggy run. But, yeah, other than that, it drives all right.
Pretty loud in the cab though. You get in here, you start driving, you get in the higher RPM, this thing is loud. It dumps right in front of the rear axle on the passenger side. So I mean, it's not the quietest truck to drive around town, but it's not the loudest either. It's definitely doable, but it's something that you guys can expect to see on the channel a little bit more, because this thing fits perfectly with everything that we have besides the all-wheel drive Trailblazer. That one just doesn't have one color, so it'll be staying around for a little bit at least. So anyhow, thanks for watching. If you guys like these videos, if you want to see more of this truck, drop a like, comments, tell us what you want to see with us do with this thing, and we'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.
Peace.